So the topic of today's discussion is how are we going to use general purpose input and output GPIO of LPC2148 microcontroller. In the previous session, we discussed that LPC2148 has two parallel ports or GPIO. One is parallel port 0, the one that I have represented on the left-hand side. It has another parallel port P1, which is represented on the right-hand side. Technically speaking, both these parallel ports are 32 bits wide, since LPC2148 is a 32-bit microcontroller. Of these 32 pins for parallel port 0, port 0.24 is not available. Similarly, port 0.26 is not available, and port 0.27 is also not available. So out of these 32, only 29 are available for parallel port 0. When it comes to parallel port 1, the complete 16 pins starting from parallel port 1.0 to 1.15 is completely not available. So which means it is available only from 16 to 31. So only these 16 pins are available. So in port 1, we have only 16. In port 0, we have 29. So totally we have 45 GPIO lines in LPC2148. These 45 lines have to be used for connecting external peripheral devices. And we should learn how to use this GPIO. And that is the discussion of today's session. This is the comparison of 8051 versus LPC2148 microcontroller. On the left-hand side, you have the activation circuit. Similarly, on the left-hand side, you have the activation circuit. And you have four parallel ports in 8051. Port 0, port 1, port 2, and port. All of them are 8-bit ports. In LPC2148, we have two parallel ports, port 0 and port 1. Technically, both the ports are 32-bit ports, but some pins are not available. In port 0, 3 pins are not available. In port 1, 16 pins are not available. But theoretically, both of them are 32-bit ports. Now, in LPC2148, the way in which we use GPIO is not as straightforward as we do in 8051. Let us take the case of a simple port. Say we take a port that is common for both the microcontrollers. Let us say we take parallel port 0, and we also take parallel port 0 in LPC2148 for our comparison, so that it is easy for you to follow. Let us start with port write. Port write means in parallel port 0, P0, I wanted to write a 8-bit data to a peripheral device. When I say write, the data flows away from microcontroller. If it is read, it is flowing towards the microcontroller. Now, in port write, 8051 microcontroller is trying to write a value. Say, for example, I have connected 8 LEDs. I want to turn on all the 8 LEDs, say, for example. So, in order to turn on all the 8 pins of parallel port 0, we use the SFR of parallel port 0. What is the SFR name of parallel port 0 in 8051? The name of the port itself. So, port 0 is equal to hexadecimal FF. So, this particular statement would write the 8 pins of parallel port 0 with 8 ones, 1111, 1111. This is what we represent in hexadecimal as hexadecimal F. Now, this is for 8051. Whereas in LPC2148, if we want to do the same thing, we have one register called IO set register. So, IO set. IO tells you that it is GPIO. Set means we are trying to write a value of 1. And finally, you have to tell whether it is port 0 or port 1 by representing a 0. 0 means port 0. If it is 1, then it is for port 1. So I write a value of IO set 0 with hexadecimal FF, 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 and FF. Okay? Because in LPC2148, it is a 32-bit port. So this is an 8-bit port. This is 8-bit. Whereas here, it is 32-bit. Okay? It is simple and straightforward. In the first one, in order to write an 8-bit value, FF, we use the name of the SFR is equal to hexadecimal FF. In this case, the name of the SFR for writing a value of 1 is IO set. Set means we are setting that particular port to 1. In the second scenario, I am trying to clear all the pins. So I have 8 LEDs here. In the second scenario, I want to clear all the 8 LEDs, let us say for example. So I use the same port. Port 0 is equal to hexadecimal 00. In this case, what will happen? All the 8 pins of parallel port 0 will become 0, which means we are clearing all the 8. Interestingly, the equivalent for that in LPC2148 is we use a different register. not the same register. So if you try to write a zero in IO set zero, nothing will happen. So we have a different register for writing a zero. In 8051, we use the same register for writing a one or a writing a zero, but for LPC 2148, we have a separate register. What is the name of that register? IO clear, CL clear. And for port zero, it is, so IO, this is O, this is zero. Don't get confused. IO set zero. This is IO clear zero. And to your surprise, many of you would, in order to clear all the 32 bits of parallel port zero of LPC 2148, what should we write here? Tell me.
0x00000000.
That is exactly is not we have to write. What we have to write here is hexadecimal, again FF. What you said is what normally we tend to think, including myself, but it is not the case. In order to clear a pin, we have to write a 1 in the clear register, not a 0. Writing a 0 either here or here will not have any effect. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
In IO set 0, if you write a 1, that particular pin will become a 1. In IO clear 0, if you write a 1, the same pin will become a 0. If you write a 0 either in set register or in clear register, it will not have any effect. So that you have to understand. So the primary difference between 8051 and LPC 2148 is we use the same SFR for writing a 0 and a 1, whereas here we use different set of one for writing a 1, we use set, for writing a 0, we use clear. That is one difference. The second difference is in order to write a value of 1, we write a 1 in the set register. In order to clear a pin, again, we have to write a 1 in the clear register, not a 0. That difference you have to. Now come the third one, namely port read. When you are reading a port, okay, let us say my data is a variable. I assign port 0 with my data. Say, for example, I am using a analog to digital converter and I am reading the 8-bit data from the ADC to parallel port. So in this case, what will be the assignment? My data is a variable that is assigned to port 0. In this case, the value of port 0 is assigned to my data. This is data read, port read. In this case, the equivalent for that in LPC 2148 is, again, my data is equal to, we use a different register in this, IO pin 0. Pin register, this SFR will return all the 32-bit values of port 0 that is assigned to my data. So we use a separate register for reading the 32-bit values of port 0. So now you have to carefully understand the same port 0 is having three different SFRs. One SFR for writing a value of 1, one SFR for writing a value of 0, and another SFR for reading the value of the same. Whereas in 8051, in all the three scenarios, we used only the name of the SFR. Here also the name of the SFRs only, but we used three different SFRs. Yes, another major difference is in parallel port 0 of LPC 2148 and in 8051, both of them are bidirectional, but we don't explicitly set the direction of parallel ports in 8051, whereas it is mandatory that you have to set the direction. So IO direction of port 0, IO direction 0 is the fourth register that you have to use. This IO direction register will configure the GPIO of LPC 2148, whether you are planning to write or whether you are planning to read data in the GPIO. So you have to explicitly configure the direction, in which direction the data is flowing. If it is flowing away from LPC 2148, it is write. If it is flowing towards the LPC 2148, it is read. So in which direction the data is flowing, whether the LPC 2148 has to read data or write data, has to be explicitly defined by using another register called IO direction. So in the place of a single SFR, namely port 0 in 8051, we have four different SFRs. One fellow for setting the direction, one fellow for writing a value of 1, another fellow for writing a value of 0, and another fellow for reading the same. And that is the primary difference between parallel port operations of 8051 versus parallel port operation of LP 1 versus 4. Simply, I use parallel port 0, P0, and I write a 1, I write a 0, I read it, I do all sorts of operation with that register. Whereas here, we have 1-1 SFR for each operation, and all the registers are 32 bits. So that is one primary difference you have done. So consolidating the discussion we had just now, the four SFRs that we used in LPC-2148 for GPIO operation are, first one is IO direction 0. The same thing for parallel port 1. Instead of 0, we have to substitute a 1. IO direction 1. Okay, so this would set the direction of the port. Direction of the port means whether the microcontroller is delivering the data or whether it's accepting. So this is for parallel port operation, setting the direction. The next one is IO set 0. IO set 0 means this SFR is used to write a value of 1 in a particular pin of parallel port 0. The same thing for parallel port 1 is IO set 2. Then, in order to write a value of 0 in any of the GPIO lines, we have to use a separate SFR, namely IO clear SFR. The same thing for parallel port 1 is IO clear 1. Last but not the least, in order to read a value from the GPIO, we use another SFR, namely IO pin SFR. So this is IO pin 0 for parallel port 0. Then this IO pin 1 for parallel. So these are the 8 SFRs, 4 for parallel port 0 and 4 for parallel port 1. If you take parallel port 0 alone, it is 4. Whereas in 8051, we used only one SFR, namely P0, and we completed all these 4 operations. In LPC-2148, we have 4 separate. So we pay some attention in understanding how to use these 4 SFRs, and later on we will see how to put this into practical use. The very first SFR is IO direction SFR. So the job of this IO direction SFR, when I say IO direction, I am saying it is common for port 0 and port 1. For port 0, you have to substitute a 0. So it is IO direction 0 for port 0. Same thing for port 1, it is IO direction. This is for port 1. So I am not discussing any particular port. In general, IO direction. So IO direction is a 32-bit SFR. So it starts from 0 and it ends at 31. So it is a 32-bit SFR. In fact, all the SFRs in LPC-2148 are 32-bit special function. Now, main concept that you have to understand is how to set the direction of a particular pin. Okay, so let us take an example of port 0. Same thing is applicable for 4. So when I say port 0, we have to deal IO direction 0. So IO direction 0, you imagine this as IO direction. This is a 32-bit SFR. So in the first example, I want you to configure pin number 8 as out. Configure pin number 8. Pin number 8 is port 0.8 as out. Again, you configure pin number 10, that is port 0.10 as. So how do we configure a particular pin of port 0 as input or output? So what is the value that we have? This is the discussion here. So in order to configure a particular pin as input, we have to write a value of 0 in that particular bit. In order to configure a particular pin as output, we have to configure that particular bit with a 1. So if you write a value of 0 in any one of this bit, that particular pin of port 0 becomes, if you write a 0, that particular pin becomes an input pin. If you write a value of 1, then it becomes an output. So to answer this question, in order to configure port 0.8 as output, we have to write a value of 1 here. And in order to configure port 0.10 as input, we have to configure a 0 here. So writing a value of 1 will make that particular pin as output pin. Writing a value of 0 in that particular bit will make that particular pin. So as an example case, in order to configure all pins as output, I want all the 32 bits of port 0 to be configured as output. So what will I write? IO direction 0 is equal to hexadecimal. All the pins are output means what? We have to write a value of 1 in all the pins. So FF, 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 and F. This 32-bit value will write once in all the pins. So all the pins are configured as output. Again, in order to configure all the pins as input, okay, what will you do? Tell me. IO direction 0 hexadecimal. In order to configure all the 32 bits of port 0 as inputs, what should you write? we have to write a value of 0. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. If you want to selectively deal any one of the pin as input or output, you have to selectively write a value of 1 and 0 in that particular pin. Okay, that involves some bit of programming that we will discuss. So three concepts you have to understand. In fact, four concepts. First concept, IO direction register is used to set the direction of data flow. Okay, it is mandatory and it is compulsory to set the direction, without which the microcontroller cannot understand whether you are trying to read or write data. So that is the first concept. Second important concept is, in order to configure a particular pin of port 0 or port 1 as input, we have to write a 0 in the direction register. In order to configure a particular pin as output, we have to write a value of 1 in the IO direction. That is the second concept. Third concept, if you want to selectively make a particular pin as output or input, we have to configure that particular pin as a 0 or a 1 accordingly. For example, writing a 1 in pin number 8 will configure that as output. Writing a 0 in pin number 10 will make that as last but not the least. Fourth concept, in order to configure all the pins of parallel port as output and input, you simply write all the pins as 1s for setting them as output and all the pins as zeros, all the bits as zeros in order to configure them as input. IO direction is a register. It is not a physical pin, but it writing a value of 0 or a 1 in this register defines the role of that particular. Writing a 0 here will configure that particular pin as input. Writing a 1 here will configure that particular pin as output. So we are defining the role of that particular pin by writing a value in this. I'll give you a simple thumb rule to understand. This is for your understanding. See, if you want to configure a particular pin as input, I, N, isn't it? So this I is, you can imagine this I as 1. What is the complement of this 1? 0. So in order to configure a particular pin as input, you have to write a 0. Take the complement of this. This is just for your remembrance. So the same pin, if you want to configure as output, so this 0 you configure as, you imagine as a 0, complement of that is 1. So you have to write a value of 1. So remember what we have to write, I am giving this. So input means, so this fellow is a 1, complement of that is a 0. So I have to write a 0 for configuring that as input. Output means this is a 0. So complement of that is 1. So I have to write a value of 1 in order to configure that as, just to remember. Okay. So a thumb rule so that it is easy for you to. So in general, IO direction register is used to set the direction of the register. The second one is IO set register. What is the purpose of this register? To write a value of pin as a 1. IO set register is used to write a value of 1 in any one of the pin of the parallel port 0 or parallel port 1. For parallel port 0, we call this as IO set 0. For parallel port 1, we call this as IO set 1. So two possible scenarios. In order to write all pins as 1s, okay, let us say, for example, for port 0, IO set 0 is equal to hexadecimal FF, 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 and FF. This will write all the bits of IO set 0 as 1s. What will happen practically? If you measure the port pin of parallel port 0, all the pins will have 3.3 volt. 1 means 3.3 volt. So this is for all pins. For selectively set any pin of port 0 or port 1 to 1, then we have to selectively make that particular bit alone to be a value of 1. So 22nd pin, if you want to write a value of 1, make 22nd bit of IO set as 1. So make 22nd bit of IO set 0 as. How to make 22nd bit of IO set 0 alone to be a 1 without disturbing the rest of the bits? Require a small amount of coding. I'm sure you must be knowing that. If you don't know, that is not a problem. We will discuss that. Similar is the case for IO clear. IO clear is used for clearing all the pins, or selectively, IO clear is used for clearing all the pins, or selectively clearing any specific pin of parallel port 0 or parallel port 1. So interestingly, IO clear 0 hexadecimal In order to clear a particular pin or all the pins, what should we write here? To write 1 here, not as 0. So FFFFFFFF in all the pins will clear all the pins of parallel ports. So this would clear all pins of ports. In order to clear a particular pin alone, say for example, I wanted to clear 17th pin of parallel port 0, then IO clear 0, make the 17th bit alone to be a 1. So write a 1 in 17. What this will do? It will clear 17th pin of port 0. So in order to clear a particular pin or write a value of 0 in that particular pin, it is necessary that you have to write a value of 1 in the clear register, not a 0. Writing a 0 in clear as well as set register will not have any. Writing a 1 in the set register will set that particular pin to 1. Writing a value of 1 in the clear register will make that particular value of pin to logical 0. Writing a value of 0 in both set register and clear register will not have any. Are you able to understand? Last but not the least, the fourth register, namely the pin register. This pin register is used to read values from the PIU for port 0. Or how to read value? It will read the entire port value. So my data is a variable. My data is equal to IO pin 0. It will read the entire values of port 0. Similarly, my data is equal to IO pin 1. This will read the entire values of port 2. Are you able to understand? So these are the four SFRs that we discussed today. So with these four SFRs, we should be able to do four possible combinations. So what are the possible combinations of activities that we can do with GPIO? The first activity is called port write. Port write means writing a value to one complete parallel port, full complete parallel. Okay. In 8051, I will write the 8051 first. Later on, you understand. So for 8051, port write means I write a value to port. Port 0 is equal to hexadecimal 32. So this is port write. I am writing a value. The second possible operation is port read. Port read means I read one complete port. So this is for output, this is for input. So for 8051, again, port or my data is equal to port. In this case, port 0 value is read to my data. So it's called port read. I am just writing for 8051. We will compare that for LPC 2.4. The third possible operation that we do for GPIO is pin write. What do you mean by pin write? Writing a value of 1 or 0 in any particular pin without disturbing the rest of the pins. This is for the complete port. This is for the complete port. This is for only one pin. See the single arrow. So I am, say for example, if I connect a LED load, I want that particular LED to be on and off. If I connect a relay, I want that particular relay alone should be on and off. It's called pin write. So in 8051, we have a beautiful bit level operation available. What is that? S bit LED is assigned to port 0 bit 7, something of this sort. Then we use LED equal to 1 and LED equal to 0 for turning on and turning off that particular pin. The last operation we have is pin read. Say for example, I have a switch. I'm trying to read a switch by using a 8051 microcontroller. Again, we have a beautiful S bit operator. S bit my switch is equal to port 0 cap 3. My data is equal to my. This would read value from a particular pin, not a port. So these are the four possible combinations of operations that we do in 8051. The equivalent of that in LPC 2148. First one is port write. For port write, we have IO set 0 and IO clear 0. IO set 0 we use for writing ones. IO clear 0 we use for writing. So we need to use two SFRs. In addition to that, we should use IO direction SFR for setting the direction of the. So this is for port write. For port read, in the direction, what should we write for configuring that particular port as write operation? Write means what? Input or output? It is output, isn't it? So for output, the first letter is O, which is a 0, which means we have to write a value of 1 here to configure that as. The next one is port read operation, where we try to read. In order to read one complete port, again, we have to configure IO direction. So IO direction 0 is configured as In this case, we have to configure that with a value of 0. So writing a 0 in the IO direction register will configure that particular port as an input port. Later, the same my data is equal to, in this case, which SFR we have to use? IO pin 0 SFR we have to use. Okay, so this is for reading one complete. For writing a particular pin and reading a particular pin, we have S-bit variables which enabled us to write a value of 1 to a particular pin without disturbing rest of the pins. The equivalent for that in LPC 2148 is not available. So we have to do some kind of programming, because in LPC 2148, there is no way possible for you to selectively write a value of 1 to a particular bit, because we don't have any bit level instructions available in LPC. In 8051, it is possible for you to do bit level operation, meaning in one complete port, we can selectively target a particular bit and write a value of 1 or a 0. That is how we are able to write a 0 or a 1 in any port pins without disturbing the rest of the pins. Whereas in LPC 2148, they always handle all 32 bits together. It is not possible for them to selectively target a particular pin either for write or read operation. So we have to do some level of programming to achieve that. So we will do that. That is not a very difficult. But the concept that you have to understand here is, for all the four possible types of operations, whether it is port read or port write or pin read, there are only four SFRs that we have to worry about. The four SFRs that we have to worry about are IO direction SFR, IO set SFR, IO clear SFR, finally IO pin SFR. These four SFRs will enable you to write a value of 0 or a 1 for the complete 32 bits of that port. And similarly, to read the complete 32 bits of the port. Later on, you do some manipulation in order to selectively write a value of 1 or selectively write a value of 0 or selectively read a particular of that particular. So that is achieved through programming. By inherent capability of the processor, that feature is not available, like it is available in 85. Okay.